chứ.
Lòng muốn nói rằng hết ký, thế sẽ mãi yêu trọn đời không hề đổi thay.
Anh được promotion in Việt Nam.
Ở Việt Nam.
Cái gì vậy?
Ôi, cô nói giọng Mỹ hả? Tôi mê Mỹ lắm đó.
Mới đi được vài bước trên sân khấu đã tự gọi mình là người mẫu rồi đúng không?
Cút ngay khỏi đây.
Hello and welcome back to Talk Vietnam. This is Quốc Khánh. If you ask some of the rising Vietnamese movie stars about their success, some like Diễm My, Kê Tiên Nguyễn, Ninh Dương Lan Ngọc, or recently Chi Pu or Lãnh Thanh, they would definitely refer to the training they have got from their acting coach, Cathy Nguyen. She is an actress, a director, and a producer who came back to her motherland, Vietnam, all the way from the U.S. to pursue her burning passion of making great movies in whatever role she might have. So what's behind that passion and where is that leading her to? Let's find out today in Talk Vietnam with our guest, Cathy Nguyen. Welcome to the show. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you. Thank you, Cam. Good to be here. I'm glad I could be to have the opportunity to be on Talk Vietnam.
Sure. Let's go back a little bit. Tell me about the early days of your career. How did you find the love for movie and actress?
I first wanted to become an actress when I was 12.
12, okay.
And I remember that I just watched Joy Luck Club.
Hmm.
And I saw Go Kyu Jin.
Hmm.
And I remember thinking, wow, she's Vietnamese. She's in the movies. I'm Vietnamese. I want to be in the movies. And so I was really inspired by her at a young age. It was a bit tough because I grew up in San Jose. Mm. I was born actually in San Jose, California. And it was not a city where they produce or make a lot of TVs or movies. Because all the movies are made in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
So the toughest part for me was finding the opportunities to be on camera, to be on film. Actually, it's when I was 16. It's even before I went to college. I really wanted to get my first agent. I submitted to over 20-something agencies in San Francisco, and I got rejected by all of them. But finally, one finally accepted me. Always one. And I remember I kept all the envelopes of all the rejection letters. And my dad started taking me to auditions, and he would take the days off work to drive me to San Francisco, which is an hour away. And after about 3 auditions, I didn't get any. So then my dad told me, he said, "Con ơi, maybe this is not the right career path for you. Maybe you should consider something else." And so I remember that I thought that was so funny. And at that time, and I kept it a secret inside that how much I really wanted to act. I was that girl in La La Land.
Okay, I can imagine.
That was me.
Yeah. All right.
I would have all my different clothes for different auditions hanging in the back of my car.
I can imagine you did a lot of auditions.
A lot. Then. And, you know, one day you can go from being a waitress to being a college student to being a nurse or a doctor, or I couldn't play doctor then, but you know what I mean. You would play many different roles when you have auditions. And so I graduated college in 2004. I had 2 nice college degrees, which I put on the shelf. And then I moved to Los Angeles. I decided to become a waitress and bartender at night.
At that time, the dream of being an actress is like gone.
No.
Or still?
No, no. I decided to become a full-time actress, which means I had to become a full-time waitress.
Okay, I got you.
And bartender at night.
Okay.
To financially take care
just
of myself.
Make a living, yep. While you taking classes and do auditions.
Yes, while I'm taking
doing
classes
auditions
and
in
auditions
the day, in the
during
daytime.
The day to get opportunities to act.
Cathy Nguyen was born in 1981 in San Jose, California, U.S., to overseas Vietnamese parents. She is the older of the 2 daughters. Cathy has already been fond of becoming an actress since she was little. At around 12 or 13 years old, Kathy frequently took part in performances at her school. Her parents did not disagree, but they were worried that she wanted to pursue an acting career. It required lots of connections, while they have none. To please her parents, Kathy Nguyen applied to study two other majors at once, economics and film, at UC Irvine in California. She didn't know anyone in the film industry back then, so she approached it step by step by taking film-related jobs in her summer vacations, from film marketing to public relations to short film production. Charming and beautiful, she secured roles in many short films, American TV adverts, and was the presenter of some community programs.
So then, yes, and I remember my first big break in a Hollywood movie was also the first movie that I got cut out in.
What was it?
It was a movie called Crossing Over, directed by Wayne Kramer, produced by the Weinstein Company. Ask yourself, so at that time, I thought, this is my big Hollywood break. I got to play the Asian girlfriend to the Asian guy.
Yeah.
And in this movie, there's all these different ethnicities trying to get their U.S. nationality.
All right.
This movie stars Harrison Ford, Ashley Judd,
wow, really?
Ray Liotta, Alice Eve, lots of big names. And I remember in this movie, I played the girlfriend to this guy. And there's a scene where I had to lose my virginity. And I had to be partially nude. We fight, I cry, and then he leaves me.
All right.
It was a very emotional scene, and I remember...
I can imagine.
Yeah, it was very emotional, and I remember I practiced for 5 days.
Okay.
Every day, like just practicing this scene so I can cry and demand, and I can lose my virginity and cry and demand, and it was very traumatizing, but I thought, oh my God, I did it. You know, I'm,
okay.
Oh God, this is gonna be my breakthrough role. Everything's gonna be amazing. At the end, of course, things happen when you're editing a movie. They have to cut it back, or for producer's reasons, you know, when you edit a movie, it could be for numerous reasons. So it got cut out. And I remember, I felt really sad. I thought, oh, there goes my hope.
You've been practicing for five days for that scene.
Not only 5 days, but when you shoot, then you practice
I'm
even more.
About that
so it's like you put a lot of your time and effort and heart and energy.
You thought it could be a breakthrough.
I thought, thinking it would be, oh, my first big Hollywood movie. But then also in that time period was also when I heard again that Victor Vu was casting for a movie called Passport to Love, Jingdun Sasu. So I went and I auditioned and I got that role. And so then I got to fly to Vietnam for the very first time.
Khi bằng lái tạm của anh sẽ bị treo một năm. Ngoài ra, anh còn phải nợ tiền phạt và đi học lớp dạy luật đi đường.
Cái gì? Lớp dạy luật đi đường? À, hay là tôi có thể chi tiền cho ai đó đi học thay cho tôi được không?
Anh nghe nè, lần này á thì anh có tiền cũng không thoát được đâu. Quan tòa có thể còn bắt anh làm 100 tiếng community service.
Community service là gì ạ?
Anh có thấy mấy người mà cáo vàng lượm rác trên đường không? Rồi sẽ biết. Cứ tạm hiểu là lao động là vinh quang cũng được.
Vâng. Thì bây giờ cô nói sao tôi nghe vậy chứ. À, thế nhưng trước khi về thì cô làm ơn cho tôi xin số điện thoại cô được không ạ? Tôi chỉ muốn xin số điện thoại của cô rồi. Một ngày nào đấy tôi mời cô đi ăn gọi để cảm ơn thôi mà.
Tôi nói lần chót. Tôi không phải là bạn anh. Hay là những người như anh. Bộ anh nghĩ có tiền là mua gì cũng được hả?
Well, back to Vietnam and Passport to Love. And you got the award. But then that was the first time you was playing a leading role in Vietnam, shooting in Vietnam and speak Vietnamese. What were some of the biggest challenges of that movie?
Speaking Vietnamese.
I guess so,
You know what I mean?
How did you
it's
overcome
hard
that?
Because I grew up with English as the language I was most comfortable. And so moving to Vietnam to become an actress, yes, I was trained to be an actress because I've been studying. But the biggest obstacle for me was acting in Vietnamese.
The language.
Yes, because It just takes me 10 times longer to remember every dialogue that a normal actor would only take a few minutes.
A longer time for your scene.
Yes, and so that just meant I had to work harder and spend more time to learn every dialogue. And my dad's actually really passionate about, you know, about acting and performing and writing. When he was young, he used to direct plays for his friends in high school. Mm. And so he actually was very excited that I'm speaking more Vietnamese, that I'm learning more about my culture. You know, I'm going back to my roots. He was excited about that, and he wanted to support that. And so he was my biggest coach, Vietnamese dialect coach, when I was doing Chinh Tinh Sa Su and Đệ Mai Tinh. I would have him on call like every time. He would probably memorize the lines as well with me to read So I would call him and I would say, you know, I would say my line and be like, you know, blah blah blah, and he would just recite them with me. Like he was just my on call like acting dialogue
coach. Mentor,
Anh Dũng ơi, anh có bao giờ thắc mắc vì sao nhà Lan dọn đi không? Biết đâu họ dọn đi vì không có đủ tiền để ở đó. Biết đâu ba má của Lan làm việc cực khổ suốt ngày và có tháng cũng không có lo cho Lan được. Bữa nào Lan cũng nhìn thấy ba má cãi lộn nhau chuyện tiền bạc. Chắc anh may mắn hơn em. Anh không lớn lên trong hoàn cảnh khó khăn. Không phải có tình yêu mà có hết đâu anh.
Đệ Mai Tinh was a movie that a lot of audiences paid attention to. It was kind of a climax in my career at that moment, meaning a lot of people knew of me, and I was getting a lot of opportunities, and I was getting a lot of offers to be on covers of magazines and photo shoots and interviews. And then a few months after that, I remember it got really quiet. I just thought, wait a minute. I'm Mai from Đệ Mai Tinh. Hello, remember me? Right? It got really quiet.
Okay.
Why? And then I realized not everyone's sitting around writing a leading role for a Vietnamese American girl in a Vietnamese movie. I got lucky to play a leading role in Chinh Tinh Sa Su because that character is Vietnamese American. And I got lucky to play Mai in Đệ Mai Tinh because they liked me for the role and they changed the character to make it as if she's a singer from Germany that came to Vietnam. So they altered the character for me to fit me. I'm not that lucky for another director to just have this dream one day to direct a Vietnamese American girl in a Vietnamese movie. So I decided.
Can't just happen many times always.
Yeah. And life doesn't give you that much luck all the time.
Right.
So then.
You gotta create something.
Yeah, so then I thought, oh, I'm gonna write my own role. I'm gonna write my own dream role that I wanna play, a character that I haven't played, a character that has many different emotions and is quirky and is neurotic and is crazy and that's fashionable because I love fashion. And I wanted to create this dream role that I wanted to play. And so that was my motivation for writing the script. I remember that at that time, you know, I gave it to Timothy Lin Bui, who's a producer, and he said, that's great, but why don't you go and you work on the story? And I go, how do you work on the story? And he showed me how. And then a month later, I sent him a story. And he was impressed because he didn't really think that I would follow his advice. Because it takes time, a lot of work to do this.
Yeah.
I did it, and he was a bit surprised. And then he supported me with Irene Trinh, who was another producer that came on board, who was also producer of Chinh Tinh Sa Su. They came and they supported me, and we hired a writer. I was working with Sun Pham at that time. And we were working on the script, and then later it went through many changes. And then we ended up working with another writing team, Tim Tory, and it took 3 years to write that script because it went through many different changes. It became Amu Ye Yok Nyong, and then in the process, the same thing with the TV show, I never want to be a producer. I don't want to do that much work, but you have
you
to.
You just have to do it.
You have to do it when it's your dream and you want to make it come true. Yeah, you have to do everything you can.
No one else can do it for you. You got to do it, yeah.
So then I became a producer, okay? because I did work to make it happen. So then I was part of the writing team and I became a producer and then I got the opportunity to, you know, act in my dream.
Con người ta thường có nhiều thứ để yêu, còn tôi thì chỉ yêu mỗi một công việc, đó là thiết kế thời trang. Vậy làm sao mà để tách mình khỏi đám đông? Tôi luôn lên kế hoạch chi tiết cho những việc cần làm. Nói một vài khen chứ, kế hoạch của tôi chạy không sai một giây nào. Tôi đã đính hôn với một anh chàng tuyệt vời, có một công việc hấp dẫn. Còn tôi thì đang làm việc cho một nhà thiết kế nổi tiếng thế giới. Phải nói là hiện giờ đời của tôi rất là...
Haribon! She's Haribon! Mais regarde-moi ça! She looks like she just stepped out from the rain.
Yes, yes, I got it.
Pourquoi elle est pas habillée?
Nothing, just a minor adjustment.
Listen, the fashion network is lurking about backstage. If they get footage of my fresh face ripping the seams of my wow piece, my career's over, and so is yours. Allez!
Roxy, what the hell happened? This picture perfectly last week.
Critics of your work say that your last couple of lines offered nothing new.
Look at this. We might as well pack our shit and move to Canada, Anne.
Just keep our boss busy. I can make this work.
3 minutes. 3 minutes.
Hold this up. Oh, it's freezing back there.
Oh, it's so cold.
She got a case of chills, but she's pushing through the water, bro.
Have you got here?
I want peace!
And then the process of how to become a director, which is the next chapter in your life. Tell me about that.
Oh, I never thought I would become a director. So actually after How to Fight in 6-Inch Heels, I started coaching actors. You know, we'd be on set and then I would share some type of acting technique or scene studies tool I learned in my acting classes when I was in Los Angeles. And I realized that a lot of people, a lot of actors I was working with, they didn't know what I knew. And so I thought, oh, okay, sure, I'll help you out.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Why not? Then later on, you know, more and more actors started coming to me. And then I started actually teaching like a small class from home. I would have.
Really?
Yeah, I would have
just suddenly
seven
become
or
a teacher.
Eight actors come over to my house at night and we would do these little technique, acting technique sessions. It was very casual. In the midst of me doing that, then Will Vu from Muse Films, he actually approached me with a script. And he sent me the script and he said, and I said, oh, are you considering me as an actress? And he goes, no, actually, I would like to offer you the role of director.
Why did he do that?
I don't know why, but he, I don't know why, but he said, what do you think about you becoming a director of this movie? And I thought,
what was going on in your mind?
I never directed before.
No experience.
Yes, and of course.
No training.
Of course, at that time, we never knew what it would become now. Mm. At the time, it was just a script for a movie. And my manager at the time, Mike Brown, he said to me, you know, I see the way you work with actors. I see the way you coach actors. And I know how you love writing scripts and making movies. You're going to be an amazing director. You're going to be one of Vietnam's top female directors.
Okay.
He said that to me.
What's so
And hard? I said, well, I said, oh, you're so sweet, Mike. Oh, I knew there's a reason why you're my manager. You're so sweet. You have so much belief in me, right? So much blind faith in me. But for some reason, like him saying it out loud made me feel really good. You know, it made me feel a little bit more confident.
I can imagine.
Right?
Yeah.
So it made me, at least there's one person that believes I could do it. right? No, there's two
more
now. Encouraging. There's two. There's two now, right? There's two now. And so the third person had to be me. Hmm. I had to believe I could do it. And so I thought, why not? Okay, fine. You know, opportunity only knocks once. What if no one ever gives me this opportunity again? Mm-hmm. I'd rather try and risk failing than regretting that why didn't I take that opportunity? And so then we worked on it for another year.
Wow.
So then it was actually
about 2 years.
2 years. And then 1 year to actually make the movie.
Okay.
Still 1 year less than Amu Yaeoknyang. So maybe the next,
4 years.
Maybe my next movie will only take 1 year,
one
right?
1 year, you're going, yeah.
Yes.
Going down, yeah, we, 4, 5, 3, and
exactly.
Then.
Exactly. Yeah.
Cut! Go!
I wanted to explore the dark deeds of humans and what we will do to revenge and hurt others when we feel we are wronged. And I hope that when viewers watch and they can see through the mistakes of our three characters in the film, that they can empathize and forgive and ultimately free themselves of pain and regret.
Chị Ca thì rất là khó tính ở trong từng cảnh quay, từng cái nét cảm xúc, từng cái nét diễn xuất của diễn viên. Và có một lần mình và chị Ca Thi không tìm ra được một cái quan điểm chung ở trong một phân đoạn đó, thì hai người đã xảy ra to tiếng khi mà phải chui đầu vào giữa một đống đất đá để mà gào thét ở trong đấy lên. Nó cũng có những sự khó khăn đấy, thì rất là hay khi mà chị Ca Thi đã xử lý được tình huống đó và đưa cảm xúc đó vào cảnh quay đó ngay tức thời, khiến cho cảnh quay diễn ra rất là thuận lợi, chứ nếu không một chút nữa là mưa là không thể quay nổi nữa.
Khi mà mình lên cái ý tưởng cho cái mood and tone á, thì mình muốn làm rõ cái thế giới của ba nhân vật. Thì cái màu trong cái nhà nó rất là lạnh, nó nhiều màu xanh. Khi mà làm việc với thiết kế Nguyễn Minh Đương thì ảnh đưa ra những cái ideas dựa lên cái đó là mình, nội thất rất là hiện đại nè, rất là lạnh lùng. Mọi thứ đang sắp xếp như là mình đang ở bảo tàng. Ở khúc đầu phim á, là Kim á, rất là gò bó, nên những cái quần áo của her nó đại diện như là một cái tulip, một cái khoa mà nó đóng lại vậy nè. Nhưng mà sau khi nhân vật Kim á, mới gặp Nhi á, là nhân vật Kim á, mới tỏa sáng ra như là một cái hoa hồng và nó nở ra vậy nè. Nhưng mà với cái việc hoa hồng thì nó cũng có những cái gai. Với nhân vật Nhi á, là she sẽ thay đổi từ ngây thơ đến nguy hiểm. Thì vì vậy là Nhi á, mặc rất là nhiều prints, rất là nhiều màu mè. Nhưng mà khi mà Nhi vào vô nhà đó thì Nhi mới hóa thân để gần gũi hơn với Kim. You work 3 years of your life to build a script, to make something come true. And then right when that dream come true is about to happen, your worst nightmare also happens. I was working with the actors during rehearsal. And my mom was very, very sick at this point. So I had to go and be with her during her last days. So it was her last week. And I knew that when I go back to visit her this time, it would be my last time. Because what I did was, during the 7 months, I knew, the doctors diagnosed that she had 6 to 9 months to live. And so what I did was I spent immediately 2 months with her. And then I would come work on the film and go back every month. I told the producers I can only be involved in this movie if every 4 weeks I can visit my mom for a month. So
yeah.
The producers were super supportive. I was so lucky.
Hmm.
So I coached the actors as best as I could. And I took off to be with my mom. And then I was very happy that I got to be with her during her last days. And then I was able to bring my mom's, we had a beautiful, beautiful celebration for her life.
Yeah.
And then I brought my mom back and we had a beautiful funeral for her here, and to bring her ashes back to Gokgam. It was like a fairy tale. I mean, I couldn't have changed it any other way. I am blessed because you know, sometimes when someone you love is passing away, sometimes if you don't know, you cannot spend time with them. But I was really blessed. I got to spend so much time with her. You know, and say everything I wanted to say to her. And so I look at it as a blessing. And then 1 week later, I had to shoot the movie. That was probably the most difficult thing I've had to ever do in my life.
I can imagine at that time.
But that gave me the strength on set because nothing on set I could not handle because I've already felt like I've been through such a challenging emotional experience.
Sure.
And so I really wanted to give it my all. And after that experience, you know, being on set, it was easy to be calm because it was crazy on set.
Mm.
It was very tiring.
Sure.
For hours and hours of day shooting. But everything that happened on set, no matter how dramatic or how anything it was nothing nearly as, it was nothing as bad as what I've been through.
Sure, I got it.
So because of that, I think I was able to stay cool.
After the success of Sister Sister in 2020, together with Tang Bui, Cathy Nguyen co-founded ACD Academy, an acting and filmmaking academy offering curriculum in acting, directing, TV hosting, and public speaking.
ACT, it stands for A Conscious Thought. It's a method that I've developed over the years.
Mm.
It was just an approach to how to explain to an actor how to act natural. I was inspired by this quote from Buddha, you know, be careful of your thoughts because they become what you say. Be careful what you say because it becomes what you do. Be careful what you do because it becomes your habits.
Mm.
Be careful of your habits because they become your character. And be careful of your character because that becomes your destiny. So actually everything starts from a thought.
Wow, your destiny.
And so then, because you want to play a different character as an actor, right? So then, therefore, in the ACT method, I kind of map out each step. First, it starts with a thought. And when you have that thought, it triggers an emotion. It makes you feel a certain way. And then with that emotion, when you feel a certain way, depending on your situation and who you're around, you'll decide to either show it or you hide your emotion, right? And then after that, you show or hide it, and then you open your mouth, and whether you talk loud or soft is because you want to show or hide it.
Hmm.
And how you move is comes from that thought. And then you say the words that are actually in the script. So there is this whole process of thought, emotion, show and hide, voice and movement that happens before you actually say the words in a script. A lot of actors don't realize that process. And so when they read a line in a script, they just look at the line. And they just, and the line says, let's say the line says, are you hungry?
Hmm.
So the 99% of actors will say, are you hungry?
Okay.
Are you hungry? Like they'll act out the line as if they're asking you, are you hungry?
Mm-hmm.
But if maybe in this scene, I have a crush on you.
Mm.
Maybe I think you're handsome.
Mm.
So I may say, oh, are you hungry?
Okay, so that's different.
Yeah, because I'm giving you, like my intention is like, oh, you wanna go on a date with me?
Mm-hmm.
It's not just, are you hungry? It's like, oh, are you hungry? But let's say I'm annoyed with you. Then it might be, oh, are you hungry? Like, hurry up.
Yeah, I can see the attitude right there.
Yes, so us as actors, we must know how to analyze the scene, to know what emotions and thoughts we have underneath that we can put underneath the words we say. So when I say a line of, are you hungry? And it has another story underneath it, it becomes a deeper performance. And every day in life, we don't have the guts or we don't really say everything that's in our thoughts. We may be politely listening to somebody and nodding our heads and being polite, but underneath we're saying, oh, I'm so hungry, I want to eat. Right? Mm. Or like...
Not me right now, okay?
you see, you're very attentive. You're picking, no. I was testing you, we were...
Had a big lunch.
But what I'm saying is that as actors, we must create
that
emotional
that
story
yeah.
underneath the lines we
I think
say.
It applies to everyday life, not just being an actor.
Yes. So basically, the whole vision for the school is ACT, on camera, on stage, and in life.
Wonderful.
So I really hope with these classes, I want to change the people's perception of how they view acting. Mm-hmm. I want people to think that, wow, acting is a skill that can help me in every day, no matter who I am in life.
Dynamic, young, professional, inspirational. These vibes can always be found at the acting and directing classes of director Kathy Nguyen. ACT Academy is running two courses, one for acting and one for directing. For a performance to be persuasive to the audience, an actor has to master the skills and control his emotions, as well as being able to analyze the scenes and build a character.
Em giỏi nhất là cười và đần. Lúc cái mặt em đần ra thì dễ nhìn lắm, còn lúc em cười thì cũng dễ nhìn luôn. Nên là em thấy nó hơi tẻ nhạt. Với cả một phần nữa là em đam mê cái gọi là ánh đèn sân khấu và phía trước máy quay. Khi là cô giảng dạy và em có những khoảnh khắc em sẽ lên em hỏi riêng cô là cô ơi thế này em muốn biểu lộ cảm xúc này thì em phải làm như nào. Cô đã tháo cho mình cái nút thắt đấy ra, mình sẽ biết cách biểu đạt đấy nhiều hơn.
Trước đây thì em thường thường là diễn theo bản năng nhiều hơn là diễn theo con đường chuyên nghiệp. Thì sau khi tham gia cái khóa học của cô Kathy Nguyen thì em cảm thấy là em trưởng thành hơn rất là nhiều. Em biết đặt cảm xúc vào câu thoại, em biết phân tích câu thoại nó như thế nào.
Cô Kathy cho mình cái điều rất là tốt nhất đó là mình feel theo cái cảm xúc của mình. Mình thả lỏng nó và mình làm nó bằng chính bản thân mình, chứ không phải là gượng ép hay là bắt chước hay là phải sử dụng một cái hình ảnh nào đó để đi theo, mà không, mà phải calm down. Đó là tôi. Tôi làm điều đó chứ không phải là diễn nữa.
In the directing class, the students learn how to work with actors and actresses in the pre-production stage and on set. It is important for the directors to create trust among actors and actresses, help them maintain good physical conditions and mentality, and define a coherent acting style throughout the film.
Cô cho khởi động trước khi mày vô bài học nè, rồi nhảy nhót cái kiểu, thì cái đó là tạo lên cho mình một cái không khí mà mình hào hứng hơn, mà mình cảm thấy là bỏ được cái sự hồi hộp và sự giống như là mà không có tự tin trước đám đông đó. Bản thân của Thanh là đạo diễn nữ và chị Kathy Nguyen cũng là đạo diễn nữ, cho nên Thanh thấy được cái sự đồng bộ đó và truyền được cái nguồn cảm hứng cho Thanh là mình cũng có thể làm đạo diễn thành công được.
More than a class, this is like a family where everyone shares with each other the joy, the hard work, and success. Each day, everyone helps each other overcome their own self and become a better version through their optimisms and passions. That's how Kathy Nguyen wants to inspire everyone.
What is it about the dark side that people talk a lot about when the relationship between a new actress and the movie directors and the producers and sort of the temptation is all kind of dark side of that industry?
Oh, okay, you're talking about the casting couch.
Casting couch.
The entertainment industry, yes. It's dangerous in a sense that it's an industry where everyone has such big dreams and big hope. And so people sometimes use that big dream against you. I remember when I first moved to Orange County, I had befriended this uncle.
Okay.
Who, you know, trying to help me. And he had this script and he wanted to offer me this leading role in this movie. And he said that because I don't have a lot of experience that he would help coach me, especially for all the intimate or sexual scenes, because I'm such a young actor and I don't know how to do these scenes. Mm-hmm. I remember I felt really uncomfortable.
I can imagine, yeah.
And I felt, no, this is wrong. But because he had become a friend, he was trying to help my dad out by being a mentor to me, mm-hmm. type of figure.
Yeah.
I felt really strange about it and I declined. I said, no, I don't feel comfortable with this. How about I play a small role? And I will one day have enough skills to then play a leading role. And he said to me, and I'll never forget this, because actually it was the best advice anyone could give me.
Okay.
He said, I don't want to waste my time with people with small dreams. I only want to help people with big dreams.
Wow.
So if you don't have a big dream, then you're not worth my time to help you.
Wow, that's...
Yeah, you see?
That's something, yeah.
I remember the time I said no. I was stubborn. I said, no, I have big dreams. He's like, okay, write them down. I said, okay, fine. I dream one day I'm gonna, you know, be a leading actress of this movie. I'm gonna do 5 movies. I'm going to produce, I'm going to direct, I'm going to write my scripts. I wanted to prove him wrong. And I wrote all these things, which at that time I was 22 and I had no experience doing anything. And I never saw him again.
Mm.
But when I graduated college, I remember moving and packing, and I found that piece of paper.
Oh, the letter.
That letter that I wrote. And on that piece of paper, like 1/3 of those dreams came true.
Wow.
Like I was able to TV host my own TV show. I produced my own TV show. I was able to be leading actress in like 3 or 4 movies.
You got it.
I really believe in the magic of daring to dream and the magic of just writing down your dreams. So I share that story because it's no different from the other story of when I thought it was my first role in Hollywood.
Yeah.
Because later on,
mm-hmm.
I didn't get to tell you the full story, but later on, Harvey Weinstein comes to Vietnam.
Oh, that guy, yeah.
This is before the Me Too. He comes to Vietnam and I remember I had an opportunity to meet him and talk to him. This was in a group setting. And I said, actually, Harvey, I was in one of your movies. And he goes, which one? And I go, I was in Crossing Over. And he goes, you're the Asian girl.
You got cut out.
And he goes, yeah, I had to. I'm sorry that, you know, the movie was too long and we had to take certain scenes out.
Yeah.
And I said, no problem, Harvey. And I shook his hand. I said, thank you. Thank you, because actually, I'm glad that scene didn't make it into the movies. Because at the time, I just thought, this is my Hollywood break.
Yeah,
I thought, oh, this movie has such amazing stars. The script is amazing. The director is amazing. It's not a big deal. But I didn't know then who I would become now, right?
Yeah.
So I think it's interesting. In life, sometimes you have these traumatic moments that you think are so bad and that you can really, it can create something really beautiful and pivotal in your career.
Yeah.
You know, I've known Kathy for a long time. One main advice that I've always told Kathy is don't wait for someone to offer you a role in a movie, right? You go out and you can develop it and you create the film that you want to make, that you want to be in, and you make it happen. And she did that.
Nói về chị Kathy Huyên thì chỉ có một từ duy nhất thôi, đó chính là tuyệt vời. Tại vì chị cảm thấy rất là may mắn khi mình đã có cơ hội để hợp tác với chị Kathy Huyên trong dự án phim điện ảnh Chị Em. Và trong suốt cái quá trình mà tập kịch bản rồi xây dựng nhân vật ấy, thì chị Kathy Huyên lúc nào cũng theo sát chị để có thể đưa Bảo Nhi đi đúng hướng. Và chị nghĩ rằng là may mắn khi mà mình đã có cơ hội làm việc một ekip rất là tuyệt vời như vậy.
Để một thực tế hơn thì trong quá trình làm việc ở trên set quay, mình chỉ muốn gọi một cái gọi là không phải là đạo diễn nữa, mà mình muốn gọi là cô giáo của mình. Vì là Kathy dạy cho mình rất là nhiều điều trên set.
Jenny và Kathy biết nhau từ rất là lâu. Từ lúc mà trước khi Jenny và Kathy về Việt Nam thì trong ở Bengali thì Jenny đã cố vũ, nói chung là hai người đã cố vũ nhau một thời gian rất là lâu. Thì để cho coi Kathy bước vào từ một diễn viên qua thêm một đạo diễn thì một cái chuyện rất là tuyệt vời. Và Jenny phải nói là Kathy rất là thành công với cái phim này.
So what do you think about the generations of the Vietnamese actors and actresses right now? What do you think about the futures of the film industry in Vietnam?
I think the future is bright.
Mm.
I think it's looking very hopeful. I mean, I've come here in 2009, and for me to see and witness how many more movies are being produced, how many more theaters are being built, how many more actors are like being developed and growing, and even the amount of actors that want to sign up for classes, people that want to learn, mm-hmm. even a lot of celebrities that still want to learn and better their craft. You know, it's, I'm seeing in the scripts, everything's getting better. Everything is growing, everything is expanding. And most important, what I see is the culture of the movie-going audiences. More people are going every weekend to watch movies. In 2009, people would buy like the bootleg DVDs on the street, right? Or they would watch movies at home on their TV. Mm. But now, no, people realize the importance of going to the theater to go support the movie industry, like you buying tickets.
So what's the plan now? Other than ACT, are you planning to have new movie, writing new script?
I'm working on a script that I will do next year, but I'm not in a rush right now. I feel opening up a business and opening up ACT Academy is, it takes a lot of work to really make it good. And mm-hmm. we're building this beginning foundation, so I need to really spend time on ACT Academy now. But I am excited for my next movie.
Yeah.
Because then I can use
it's
everything.
It's gonna be less than 3 years, 2 years.
Okay, hopefully it's only 1 year for the writing of the script. So, so I'm excited for, because what I know now is definitely more than I knew before.
Sure.
And so I'm excited for all those life experiences to come together in the next project.
Amazing.
Yeah.
If you found that letter again and you look at the list right now,
yeah.
you think you have ticked all the lists?
I think I did more. I didn't write. Right? I think I did more now by this time.
Dare to dream, and now you actually realize your dream.
There was a time when I was in Vietnam. There were times I had hardships, and I wasn't sure if I can make it out here because mm-hmm. I'm not 100% local Vietnamese.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm still Americanized, right? And I still mm-hmm. stand out. And there was times I thought, no, I meant to come to Vietnam to become an actress. And then I thought, no, maybe I'm not, because clearly there's not many roles being offered for me here, right? Oh, I get it. Maybe I'm meant to come to Vietnam to write scripts about amazing, strong women characters, you know? And then I thought, no, there's a lot of other writers as well here, you know? I'm not the only one, right? And then I thought, maybe I'm meant to direct, like, movies with amazing performances. And then I realized, no, I'm not the only director here in Vietnam. And I thought, well, maybe I'm meant to come here to spread the love of acting.
Maybe and that's destiny.
And then I thought, yeah, no one's doing that right now. So I guess I should do it. I must do it. Because if I don't do it, who will? So that's my my mission for now.
Good luck with that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, that's the story of Kathy Nguyen. I call her an actress, a producer, a director, a teacher at ACT Academy. She doesn't have just a passion of being an actress. She has everything was born with her, being a producer and directors, and she came back to Vietnam to realize her dream. And now she's building a foundation of the next generations of actors and actresses with her school and all the education projects. And of course, we can't wait to see her next movie. So thank you so much and good luck.
Thank you so much.
Thank you,
Ken. Thank you for having me on the show.
Thank you.